Hi everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I am going to show you how to load files from Snowflake stored procedure. This is the 17th video from Snowflake stored procedures playlist. Assumptions, see, batch mode, we are running our project in batch mode and there is no ETL tool, and then using your own framework, like as I said that we don't have any ETL tool, we have to build our own framework to do all the day-to-day activities as part of, you know, in our project to build the logic. So, and also file name contains with current date format, like below from internal or external stage. If you see file name, this is the internal stage. In this demo, I am going to use the Snowflake internal stage. This will be applicable for external stage also. So here, if you see my stage, we have a department CSV file is there with July 31st and August 1st. So what is the latest file from this one? This is the latest file. So, and current date or current date. So in my system, current date is 0801. That's why I have uploaded the two files in the internal stage. Now I'm going to load latest file with the current date or current date 0801.cs file into department table by using the Snowflake stored procedure with the help of copy command. Please note that inside stored procedure also we are going to use the copy command. That copy command will be executing inside Snowflake stored procedure. Let's get start demo. Let me set the context info to my session, and I am going to show you the what are the files in the my stage. So here, with starting with the department files. Okay, see, here we have two files. One is the ending with 2021 07 31st, and another file is the 2021 August 1st. What is the my current date? From, if you see here, current date from Snowflake database, we have a August 1st. So out of these two files, August 8th file should pick, okay, and we should load that file only, not both files. So for that, as I said that we are going to create the sp underscore load files procedure with variables, and this is the helper function to log the information. And here, first, before, I mean, you know, starting this one as part of the step 10, truncate table before loading. So with this statement, I am going to truncate the table. After that, get the current date, because we need to get the current date. So for that, this is the syntax to get the current date. Snowflake.create statement, inside that we have a select 2_char current date YYMMDD format. Okay. And then iterating the, this is the, once you execute this query, the result set will be stored into this variable. This is the result set variable. From there, you need to iterate, because this going to return only one row with one column. That's why I am not using the while loop over here. No need to iterate. You can directly use the call the next method by using this result set. After that, by using the get column values method from result set, you can store the current date value into lv underscore file underscore load date. Okay, this is the logging information. And finally, step 30, copy command. Here we are going to execute the copy command. What I am going to do here, I am creating copy command in the string, okay, with back quoted copy into department. Here, please note that I am everything hard coded except file, the current date format. So David table name and stage name we are hard coding. After that, DEPT, first part, okay, above the part file name is hard coded. Only date part I am taking from the variable, and CSV also hard coded .csv. And file format name is equal to my format. Please note that this already I have created. And then whatever that syntax, here I am logging. So if this would be useful, I mean, if you are going to get any error, so that you can check that what is that error after executing the procedure. And then finally you call that statement over here, and here return output dot array or return success. So why I am using the output dot array? Logging. I want to show you the output. If everything looks fine, then end up the before checking this into your SVN or any version tool, you can use the return success. Okay, this is the exception catch block. Okay, if there is any error, then it will show you that what step it will fail like that. Now let me compile this procedure. I will provide this procedure in the description. Okay. Function sp underscore load underscore file successfully created. Now what I am going to do, let me show you the once again file names. Here two files are there. As per the current date, this file should get load. Okay, I already uploaded the file. There are four records are there in the file. Now here I am going to copy. Before loading, just let me check the data. Yeah, data is there. So anyhow, this procedure, inside procedure, the truncation will be happening, or else what I will do, before executing, I will just delete two records. Delete from DEPT where DEPT number in, because we have four department numbers, 10, 20. I'm deleting 10 and 20. Okay, so that we have only two rows. Okay, now let me show you the how many rows are there in this table. Two rows are there. Now I am going to run the procedure, call sp load files. Okay, see, this is the log information where first one is the load date. So we are taking the load date as this one. This part will be concatenate to our variable file name. So we already done that one. See, copy into, this is the our actual copy statement. So if you want, you can, there is in the copy button, you can get it to and paste into here also. Now let me see the procedure has been executed successfully without any error. Now let me see whether data has been truncated and loaded. Yes, you see, earlier before running the procedure, there are two rows. Now we have a four rows, because whatever that existing rows have been truncated from the table and loaded again from this procedure. This is the one way where we have loaded all the hard coded values except the date format. Now what I am going to show you, instead of hard coding all the table name and file stage name and file name, what I am going to do, I am passing the input arguments. Okay, see here, another procedure sp underscore load underscore files underscore one, p underscore table name varchar, p underscore stage name and p underscore file name. All the threes will be arguments, will passing as a arguments. Now everything is same here. First step number 10, truncate before loading the table. So this is the truncation. Okay, because you know, table name, based on whatever that table name we are passing, based on that it will truncate. After that we are going to run the copy command. Here we no need to take, because we are passing the entire file name as input name. That's why, and here also, see, copy into your table name. Please note that when you are going to use the input parameters as part of inside a SQL statement, you have to use the uppercase. Okay, uppercase from @ stage name and file name. Remaining file format is same. Now this is the logging information. After that, executing the copy command with this. Now here return output underscore array is the variable, array variable, and here catch block where if there is any error, then we will see the actual error from this catch block. Now let me compile this procedure. Function sp underscore load underscore files underscore one successfully created. Now what I am going to do, let me, because this is the file. Okay, the table name, I am passing the table name DEPT, my stage and DEPT. This exact, I am passing the entire, because this is our assumption, correct? So we know the file name, so that's why we are passing this one. Okay, let me execute this one. Before executing the, let me delete two records. Delete from DEPT where, because four rows are there already in the, so this time I am going to truncate, delete two rows, 40 and department 40 and 30. So now two rows have been deleted. After that, if you see select star from DEPT, here we have two rows only, department 10. After running this procedure, these two rows should be truncated, and whatever that file, I mean having four records in the file, those five rows should be inserted into DEPT table, because we are passing the table name as the DEPT. See, this is the command copy into DEPT from my stage, and this is the file name. That's all. So now procedure has been executed successfully. Now we'll see the data from department table. See, four rows are there. This is the how you can load. And please note that here I am passing the file names here. Instead of passing the all these arguments, you can maintain one configuration table where you can mention all the details and read that data and load one by one. You can load the all the files from the single procedure also. Okay, and also please note that we can schedule this procedure, run it every day at particular time by using the Snowflake tasks also. That I will make one more video how we are going to schedule a stored procedure which runs every day at particular time. Yeah, that's all from this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Click on bell icon for notification. Like it and share it to your friends. Thank you once again.